بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا محمد في الأولين وفي الآخرين وفي الملأ الأعلى إلى يوم الدين، خاتم الأنبياء وسيد المرسلين، ورحمة الله تعالى للعالمين، النبي العربي المبين الأمين. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك عليه وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين، واشملنا يا رب معهم برحمتك أنت أرحم الراحمين. الحمد لله الذي هدانا لهذا وما كنا لنهتدي لولا أن هدانا الله. الحمد لله. This is the third time we meet today, and we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make these gathering for His sake subhanahu wa ta'ala and accept us all. Allahumma ameen. All praise and glory to Allah. We always praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for all the blessings, for all the favors, for all His ni'mah He has bestowed upon us. وَمَا بِكُم مِن نِعْمَةٍ فَمِنَ اللَّهِ. Like every Friday, right after Salat al-Isha, we try to reflect on the same topic of khutbah. We try our best not to make khutbah al-Jum'ah that long. I mean, we try to make it like, we go like in the middle, in between. We don't make it so long. That's why we try to take also a few minutes after Salat al-Isha to continue the same topic. If we have any, you know, if you have any question, if you have anything, we need to continue with the same topic. What was our topic today?
Toba.
MashaAllah, everyone is ready to answer. I wasn't expecting that, by the way. But it's perfect, alhamdulillah. Our topic today was at-tawba, repentance, to make repentance, to turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and repentance. And we've mentioned that we need to do this every single day. It's not just like something we do after committing a mistake or after committing a sin. This is only one way. But the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam tells that he was making tawbah to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala 100 times a day. And we talked enough about this point, and we asked Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant us this mentality of always asking for forgiveness and always turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and repentance. Allahumma ameen. Why do we say we need to make repentance every day and all the time? Why? Let's say that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has blessed us with so many ni'am and so many blessings. وَإِن تَعُدُّ نِعْمَةَ اللَّهِ لَا تُحْصُوهَا. If you try to count the blessings of Allah, you will never be able to enumerate them. So, in return, are we entitled to show gratitude to Allah and to thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for each and every ni'mah we have? We can't. Even if we try, we will never be able to do this. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَفِي أَنفُسِكُمْ أَفَلَا تُبَصِرُونَ. And just contemplate about your own self and how many blessings and how many ni'am that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had granted you. So if we are always short in terms of thanking Allah, so we will make repentance for this, so that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept us and accept our shortcomings in terms of showing gratitude to Him subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is one thing. The second thing is to be always grateful to Allah, no matter what. Rawat Sayyidat Aisha radiallahu anha wa arda. يعني قالت أو روت كان النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يقوم من الليل حتى تتفطر قدماه فقلت قال السيدة عائشة لماذا تفعل هذا وقد غفر الله لك ما تقدم من ذنبك وما تأخر فقال صلى الله عليه وسلم أفلا أكون عبدا شكورا. So السيدة عائشة may Allah be pleased with her, she narrated that the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم kept standing during night and praying to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, kept standing so long that his feet would crack from the long standing in the night prayer. And then as Sayyidah Aisha radiallahu anha, she asked Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, why do you have to do all of that? You're already, as you mentioned, you have no sins at all. He says sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, should I not be a thankful servant to Allah? I have to be thankful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this is the way how we should treat and look at the concept of gratitude towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. استمعوا لهذا الحديث جيدا. لنعلم أهمية التوبة وماهية التوبة. يقول النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم: لو لم تذنبوا لذهب الله بكم ولجاء بقوم يذنبون فيستغفرون الله تعالى فيغفر لهم. It's a common sense that everyone commits mistakes and commits sins at a point in time. We ask Allah to forgive us all. We are weak and we are human, and this is the way how we've been created and designed. If we are like angels, if we don't commit any mistake, then what is the point of repentance? And what is the point of forgiveness, right? So if there is the concept of repentance, tawbah, and the forgiveness actually comes after committing a sin. So we are liable to commit sins. Of course, this is not like, you know, a license for everyone to do whatever you want and then make repentance. No, we try our best to be on the track and to be following the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And if we fall into the trap of shaitan, we get back to Allah, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala always forget. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. So he says sallallahu alaihi wasallam, وَالَّذِي نَفْسِي بِيَدِي, by the one in whose hand my soul is, لَوْ لَمْ تُذْنِبُوا لَذَهَبَ اللَّهُ بِكُمْ. Were you not to commit sins, Allah will replace you with people who commit sins and then seek for forgiveness from Allah, and Allah would forgive them. لَذَهَبَ اللَّهُ بِكُمْ وَلَجَاءَ بِقَوْمِ يُذْنِبُونَ فَيَسْتَغْفِرُونَ اللَّهَ تَعَالَى فَيَغْفِرَ لَهُمْ. So this shows us how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and how merciful Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is. So take advantage of this. Try your best to be always good. We can't be perfect, but we can be always trying. We're not required to be perfect, but we are required to always keep trying. If we commit a sin, we know where to go. Just go back to Allah. Very simple. Very easy. Allahu yaghdab in tarakta su'ala. Wa baniy adama hina yus'al yaghdab. If you get to one of your friends or one of your brothers and you ask him for money one day, the second day, the third day, 3 days in a row, he start getting, you know, annoyed and get like a burden. Right? But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala actually gets angry with those people who are not getting back to him. So quite contrary, when you get, you know, putting any pressure on people, at a point in time they can't stand it. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves you to get back to him, make dua and seek for forgiveness all the time. Allahu yaghdabu in tarakta su'alahu wa baniya adama hina yus'alu yaghdabu. So it's never too late. It's never too late. No matter what happened in the past, still, so long as, يعني لم تبلغ الروح في القوم, so long as we are able to breathe, we have the full, you know, we could reason everything. We're still alive, simple. And the sun does not come from the west, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives you the forgiveness. What should we do? Just say astaghfirullah between you and Allah and act accordingly. As we mentioned, when we seek forgiveness, we're trying to stop committing the sin, to feel sorry and to determine not to get back to the sin, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgets. Subhanahu. Allah tabarak wa ta'ala yaqul fi al-hadith al-qudusi al-sharif, al-hadith al-qudusi fi ghayat al-azma, talmas al-qulub. Ish kida wala hik? Yani lamma yunadi Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ala ibadih, ya ibadih, إنكم تخطئون بالليل والنهار وأنا أغفر الذنوب جميعا فاستغفروني أغفر لكم. شوف الجمال. يا عبادي, أو يا ابن آدم, يعني في حديث آخر, لو بلغت ذنوبك عنان السماء, زي ما قلنا في الخطبة, ثم جئتني لا تشرك بي شيئا غفرت لك ما كان منك ولا أبالي. الله تبارك وتعالى يقول فاذكروني أذكركم. So Allah tabarak wa ta'ala said, if you remember me, I remember you back. And in the holy hadith, if you forget me, I still remember you. Just imagine that Allah does not need any one of us, but He always offers His mercy, offers His forgiveness.
we need to take a national step because we need Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is how the concept of repentance should be in our day-to-day life. It's not something we do every week or every month or when we commit a sin. No, we have to do it every day. Astaghfirullah wa atubu ilayh. And the smart believer is the one. When you go to bed, at the end of your day, try to reflect on the whole day. If there is any mistake, and there should be some shortcomings, then ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for forgiveness before going to bed. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala promised He will forgive. So, في حديث آخر يقول النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم مخبرا عن رب العزة سبحانه ما تقرب إلي عبدي بشيء أحب إلي مما افترضته عليه ولا يزال عبدي يتقرب إلي بالنوافل. وهو ده نوع من أنواع التوبة, تودد والتقرب إلى الله حتى أحبه. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, and He declared it, that the best actions we could do are those actions He subhanahu wa ta'ala obligated upon us, like prayers. And this is actually the highest priority in our religion, as prayers, as salah. وَلَا يَزَالُ عَبْدِي يَتَقَرَّبُ إِلَيَّ بِالنَّوَافِلِ حَتَّى أُحِبَّهِ. The more you perform nawafil, you perform extra voluntarily prayers, the more you get closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And if so, Allah will love you. What is the result? فَإِذَا أَحْبَبْتُهُ كُنْتُ سَمْعَهُ الَّذِي يَسْمَعُ بِهِ وَبَصَرَهُ الَّذِي يُبْصِرُ بِهِ وَيَدَهُ الَّذِي يَبْطِشُ بِهَا وَرِجْلَهُ الَّذِي يَمْشِي بِهَا وَلَئِنْ سَأَلَنِي لَأُعْطِيَنَّ وَلَئِنْ دَعَانِي لَأُجِيبَنَّ أو كما قال صلى الله عليه وسلم مخبرا عن ربه وعن رسوله تبارك وتعالى. So if Allah loves us, if Allah loves you in this hadith, as He mentioned صلى الله عليه وسلم, كنت سمعه الذي يسمع به, I'll be His hearing with which He hears. The meaning is Allah will protect you from hearing something, you know, bad that affects your heart or takes you away from the straight path. And the same thing with our eyes, our hands, our leg, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us, the whole thing, protect us all the way. And also Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives us ijabah for our dua when we try to get closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with performing so much voluntarily prayers, sunnah or nawafil. And overall, our purpose and our methodology in this life is one verse, very simple. وَعْبُدْ رَبَّكَ حَتَّى يَأْتِيَكَ الْيَقِينَ. مَا هُوَ الْيَقِينَ؟ الْمَوْتِ. You have worship Allah, worship your Lord, tell the certainty, al-yaqeen, the certain thing, which is al-yaqeen, nobody doubt about death, right? No matter how your the belief, the faith, the color, the ethnicity, the culture, all humanity knows that at a point in time will die. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives us this in brief. وَعْبُدْ رَبَّكَ حَتَّى يَأْتِيَكَ الْيَقِينَ. Keep on this track. Worship your Lord till the time of death. On our journey to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we will commit sins. Of course, to diagnose this, you have the track of tawbah. To say astaghfirullah, to seek forgiveness, to give back to Allah. And Allah always forgets. Once your heart is pure and you want Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to wipe out your sins, He will grant His forgiveness subhanahu wa ta'ala right away. As we mentioned, مَا يَفْعَلُ اللَّهُ بِعْذَلِكُمْ إِنْ شَكَرْتُمْ وَأَمَنْتُمْ. You know, nothing will benefit Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala if we will be tortured, right? Or even the other way. If there is a benefit, we will get this benefit. And if there is a harmful thing, it will befall us. So, بَلْ الْإِنسَانُ عَلَى نَفْسِهِ بَصِيرًا. We need to be intelligent enough to make the most of this privilege that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had given us. Every day, make repentance to Allah, you're able before going to bed to get the forgiveness for all what happened during your day. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَاللَّهُ غَفُورٌ رَحِيمٌ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the most forgiving, the most merciful. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to allow us make tawbah, nasuha, real and genuine tawbah, and to accept us all and to shower us with His mercy and forgiveness. اللهم آمين. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله العظيم لي ولكم ونراكم إن شاء الله تعالى في الصباح. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.